And welcome back. Absolutely gorgeous day across southern Colorado, but that's about to change and start to feel a bit more like fall. Start things off with our sky scan now. That area of low pressure that's been cooking off of the California coast has made it inland, and notice how much South Pacific moisture that is pulling up into the states right now. Utah, Arizona getting absolutely hammered, and that, folks, is what is headed our way. Currently across the board, we're seeing some higher elevation shower activity. Literally a good chunk of western Colorado is actually under a flood warning right now. Nowhere in our area is of concern tonight. However, as we start to move into Sunday and Monday, there's a good chance we're going to see some heavy rains moving through the area. It doesn't take a meteorologist to tell you how much rain is in the forecast with that kind of moisture stream. As for the skycast, here's how things are going to play out. So again, shower activity throughout the evening hours is pretty much going to stay into the higher elevations. We're not expecting really any to make it into eastern Colorado, but notice that big patch of moisture there that's just starting to come off of that area of low pressure. That's going to start moving our way Sunday morning. So again, Sunday morning, fairly clear across eastern Colorado. Not much cloud cover. The higher elevations, we're going to start seeing some cloud cover build there. So again, if you're into the Woodland Park area, might see a little shower activity in the morning, but out in eastern Colorado, going to stay relatively dry. However, as the day progresses, that's when a few of those showers are going to break loose across the mountains and start to move through the plains area. So again, spotty showers between 2 and 6 tomorrow. Not overly heavy. Monday right now, folks, is the day of biggest concern. So again, as you saw, a few of those little spotty showers will break loose, but for the most part, eastern Colorado is going to stay relatively dry. Now, when we turn on that skycast precipitation, this is going to show us where the heaviest rain is expected. So again, come Sunday morning, we're going to start to see that heaviest rain again, western Colorado and over the mountains. As the day progresses, we'll see a little bit break loose into our area, but for the most part, the heaviest shower activity, again, is going to stay into western Colorado tomorrow. That will shift to eastern Colorado as Monday winds around. As for lows tonight, looking at the mid-50s pretty much all across the board, and low 50s into the foothills, 51 here into the Springs, 56 into La Junta, Lamar, 57 degrees, and those temperatures are also going to taper off. What happens is you get a lot of that cooler air from Canada sinking into those big troughs that that area of low pressure is going to create, and that's what's going to help to cool down those temperatures a little bit. As for tomorrow's highs, another day in the 80s for eastern Colorado, and that's just going to help to kind of instigate a little bit of that shower activity as well. 83 here into Pueblo, 76 into the Springs, and a few high 60s as we move into the mountain locations. Over the next 7 days, here's where it gets a little bit interesting for us, folks. Again, start out with about 76 degrees to tail out your weekend, and then Monday, that is the day we really want to keep our eye on. Showers are going to move through the area Sunday afternoon, but again, Monday, folks, I cannot stress that enough. We need to keep our eye to the sky there because a lot of elements are coming together, especially for eastern Colorado, where we might even see some severe thunderstorms roll out of this system. Into the Pueblo region, decent shot of moisture there as well, about 79 degrees, cooling down after the 80-degree mark on the Sunday, 40s for your overnight lows there. Into Canyon City, we're looking at the 70-degree mark pretty much all week long, and then the 60s to follow there, 40s for your overnight lows. And Teller County, going to be a little bit better coverage on these storms, and you're going to start to see those rain showers kick up again, primarily Sunday into Monday. Monday, again, the biggest day of concern right now, with some heavy shower activity moving through the areas. And then notice those temperatures, 50s for the week to follow, and might even be a dose of snow come the tail end of next week overnight lows in about that 32-degree mark.
So the weather, kind of the warm weather, leaving us with a bang then.
Yeah,
on Monday,
most definitely. Most definitely. Yeah, it's kind of toying with us a little bit here this week. It'll get interesting.
All right, Jason. And,